Hey students, good morning once again. Let's start with first poem of your PT2, The Lake Isle of Innisfree. Anyone who can understand anything from the title of the poem? Any idea that comes in your mind? You understand the meaning of lake, you understand the meaning of isle. Isle here refers to island. Yes, any idea that comes in your mind about the lake or isle, island? What is lake? What is island? You might have read all these things in your social science. Island kya hota hai? Lake kya hoti hai? Yes, quickly raise your hands. Come forward. Yes, beta. What is an island? Yes, Ankit, beta.
An island is a piece of land surrounded by water on all sides.
Yes, it is a piece of land that is surrounded by water from all sides. And what is lake? Anyone else? Yes. Raise your hands. What is a lake? What is a lake? One raising hand. फॉरवर्ड बेटा लेक आपने बहुत सी लेक देखी भी होंगी सुनी भी होगी क्या होती है लेक यस हितेश्री सोनी
मैम अ लार्ज एरिया ऑफ लैंड सराउंडेड विद वाटर
इट्स नॉट सराउंडेड विद वाटर देयर इज वाटर इन दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया पानी होता है ना लेक जिसको हम लेक कहते हैं पानी होता है
लेक इज अ स्मॉल वाटर बॉडी
यस इट्स स्मॉल वाटर बॉडी यू कैन मेंशन एनी लेक यू हैव विजिटेड एनी लेक देखी कभी आपने लेक कहीं कभी हैव यू विजिटेड एनी लेक
यस मैम
व्हिच लेक कैन यू नेम
लेक चंडीगढ़ देयर इज अ सुहाना लेक
देयर इज अ
Sahara Lake.
Sahara or it is Sukhna Lake?
Yes, Sukhna.
Sukhna Lake. In Chandigarh, there is a Sukhna Lake. And I think many students might have seen it. Bahut se logon ne ye dekhi hogi aur wahan par log ghoomne ke liye jaate hain picnic ke liye. It's a good area, peaceful area, having water and you get coolness of the water there. Now, this poem, which is written or you can say composed by William Butler Yeats. Short में इसका नाम है W.B. Yeats. Yeats के नाम से जाना जाता है ये poet. And this poem is written by, composed by W.B. Yeats, the Lake of Innisfree. Innisfree is the name of a place mentioned here. And the poet is explaining us about the beauty of the lake island of Innisfree. Innisfree में एक island है जहाँ पर lake है जिसके बारे में ही वो हमें explain कर रहा है. And that is his childhood place. His childhood memories are attached with this lake. So the poet wants to live there in his young age also. As many times it happens, people have to leave their childhood place due to some work, due to some job, or due to some other circumstances. And the same way, the poet has to leave that place, but he expresses his desire in this poem by telling us the beauty of that place, the natural beauty of that place. And he expresses his strong desire to go back to that area of the lake of Innisfree so that he could enjoy the beauty of nature once again and get peace of mind. Because now he is living in the city, and city life, you understand, it is full of hustle and bustle, hurriness, crowd, loud noise, pollution. So the city life and the village life or the life in the natural surroundings is far better than the city life. So the poet wants to go back to that place of peaceful atmosphere near the lake of Innisfree, and he wants to spend his life there. So this well-known poem explores the poet's longing for the peace and tranquility of Innisfree, a place where he spent a lot of time as a boy. And this poem is a lyric. Lyric, you understand, which gives you the rhyme or the musical tone. Yeah. So this poem, it's a very well-known poem, and it tells us about the poet's longing. Longing means desire for peace. Peace, samajhte ho? Shanti. Quietness, no show, rush, no show, noise, कोई शोर शराबा ना हो जहाँ पर मन की शांति जो है मिले. And tranquility, tranquility is again quietness and the peaceful atmosphere of Innisfree. Innisfree is the name of a place where he spent a lot of time as a boy, as I already told you that it is a place where he spent his childhood period as a boy, and he loved that place. So this poem, which is given in the form of a lyric, let's have the reading of the poem, then we'll come to know what he expresses about this area and what he tells us about the city life and why he wants to live in this place of Innisfree. I will arise and go now and go to Innisfree and small cabin built there of clay and petals made. 9 bean rows will I have there, a hive for the honeybee, and live alone in the bee-loved glade. From the very the first stanza, we come to know that the poet is expressing his desire, his longing to go back to Innisfree and live there. He wants to live at that place only. Why he wants to live there, that he is explaining us. He says, I will arise and go now. I will get up from this place now. Arise, ek baar jaagne ke liye bhi keh sakta hai ki main abhi tak soya hua tha. That means he was not aware about this thing. Yahan sone ka matlab kya hai? He was not aware of this thing, that there would be a lot of difference between the city life and the village life. And there, the life is full of hurry only. Half God said only is a degree of necessity. Okay? So he felt that now he had realized, and he will arise, means he will get up now and will go now to Innisfree. He will go to this place of Innisfree, which is a small place and full of peace. And a small cabin built there of clay and petals made. What he desires now, that he will go there, he will make a small cabin that will be built of clay and petals. Sukna, please keep yourself mute, whosoever has unmuted Saksham. What he desires, that he would build a small cabin. Cabin, you can say here, just like a box or a cottage. He will make a small cabin, apna box, cottage banayega, of clay and petals. Clay hota hai, mitti, samajhte ho na, mitti se, and petals, the reeds. Jaise grass ke tinke, ghas ke tinke ho, aise, jaise chota chota bans ke tinke hote hain, jise aapne gaon mein dekha hoga, cottages bani hoti hain. So he wanted to make a cabin, a cottage, of clay and petals. Petals, the reeds, or twisted sticks for making fence and walls. Diwari banane ke liye, ya char diwari banane ke liye, jo ghas ke tinke, ya patle se lakdi hoti hai, jisko karna bolte hai, Punjabi mein. No? To uske tinkon ko jod jod kar, jo diwar se banai jati hai, char diwari banai jati hai, that is known as petals. So he wanted to make a cabin, a cottage of clay and petals. 9 bean rows will I have there. What else he would have there? He wanted that he would have 9 bean rows. Bean rows here refers to the vegetables. Beans, okay, na sabjiyan. So wo kya chahta hai ki that he will have 9 rows, 9 lines of the beans. That means he will have green vegetables there. A hive for the honey bee. And then he will have हाइव फॉर द हनी बी. हाइव क्या होता है? हनी बी मधुमक्खियां होती है. जब मधुमक्खियां का हाइव मीन्स अ लिविंग प्लेस, छत्ता उनका जहाँ ग्रुप बनाकर वो रहती हैं. हनी बी मधुमक्खियां रहती हैं एक अपना छत्ता सा बना के, जिसमें से कि शहद हनी जो है वो निकाला जाता है. तो व्हाट ही वांटेड टू टेक केयर एंड कीप द हनी बी आल्सो इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ ग्रुप, कि वो हनी बी को भी वहां पर पालेगा, मतलब उस एरिया में जहाँ पर वो अपनी कॉटेज बनाएगा मिट्टी और मेटल्स के साथ, क्ले और मेटल्स के साथ, वहां वो 9 रोज बीन्स की लगाएगा. एंड देन ही विल हैव अ हाइव ऑफ हनी बी and live alone in the bee love glade, and he would live there all alone in quietness, in peace, in the bee love glade, only in the noise of the bees. Glade here refers to the buzzing sound of the bees, or the glade also refers to the open space, open area, bee love glade, the open area that will be full of the noise of the bees only. वहाँ और कोई शोर शराबा नहीं होगा. शहरों में कैसा शोर शराबा होता है? Vehicles का, transport का, factories का, industries का, ठीक है, और music का बहुत ज्यादा शोर शराबा होता है city life में. And he does not like that noise, but he wanted to have the voice, the buzzing sound of the bees. Bee loud here refers to the buzzing sound of the bees in the open area. Glade means the open space or the clear or the open area. So what he wanted in the first stanza, what he has told us, that he had got awareness now. He will get up now and go to, in his way, he will prepare a small cottage there of clay and metals. He will have 9 rows of beans there. That means the green vegetables he will have. That means greenery all around. Then he will have a hive of the honeybee, and he would enjoy the buzzing sound of the bees in that open area, living all alone. He wants to go away from the crowded area of the city life and the noise pollution of the city life. He wanted to enjoy only the beauty of nature, the buzzing sound of the bees. Coming to the second stanza, and I shall have some peace there. For peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the wheels of the morning to where the cricket sings. There midnights all a glimmer and noon a purple glow and evenings full of linnet's wings. And the first stanza he has explained about the natural things, that is clay, petals, beans, then honeybee, hive of honeybee. In the next stanza, again he gives reference to the beauty of the nature in the open areas, in the village life, in the country life, what type of life he would be enjoying there. He says that I shall have some peace there by living in that lonely cottage in the open area and listening to the sound of the buzzing of the bees. He will enjoy peace of mind. He will have some peace there. For peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the wheels of the morning. Because according to him, the peace comes in the small drops. It is a mist hoti hai, mist. Mist samajhte ho? Dhund girti hai, usme se paani ki ek ek drop banti hai beech mein se. Aap dekhte ho jab ek jagah par fog ya mist jo hai padi rehti hai, thodi der ke baad aap dekhte ho wahan paani ki drops nazar aane shuru ho jati hai. So it comes very slowly in the form of drops. So he says, therefore peace comes dropping slow. That peace will come dropping very slowly. It will drop like the mist in a very small drops, dropping from the wheels of the morning to where the cricket sings. And it will come from the wheels of the morning means from the cover. Jaise wheel hota hai, parde ke liye use kiya jata hai. Jaise sir pe dupatta lo, usko aage kar lo, that is the wheel. तो वो क्या कह रहा है कि पीस विल कम फ्रॉम द कवर ऑफ द मॉर्निंग, जैसे ही मॉर्निंग होगी और वो उसको मिस्ट की ड्रॉप्स जो है वो पानी में नजर आएंगी, दैट विल गिव हिम पीस ऑफ माइंड बिकॉज इट गिव्स अ ब्यूटीफुल पिक्चर. व्हेन मिस्ट इज स्प्रेड ऑल ओवर ऑन द ग्रीन एरिया एंड इट कन्वर्ट्स इनटू ड्रॉप्स ऑफ वाटर एंड दैट गिव्स अ ब्यूटीफुल इमेज और द पिक्चर. एंड व्हाट ही फील्स that peace will come automatically with the coming of the mist and it will come with the wheels of the morning. As the wheel of the morning will be uncovered, andhera khatam hoga, raat khatam hogi, aur din niklega, and those drops will be seen from the cover of the morning to where the cricket sings. And then in that morning, cricket will sing. Cricket is a bird that gives a lively and happy atmosphere to the area. The singing of the cricket is considered. Cricket is the bird that sings in a very melodious tone. So he would like to enjoy the cricket singing in the morning time with the coming of the drops, and those drops and the singing of the cricket will give him peace. There, midnights all are glimmer, and then at the midnight time, he will again enjoy the glimmering of the insects. रात के टाइम एक होता है जुगनू टाइप सा छोटा सा इंसेक्ट होता है जो ऐसे लगता है जैसे लाइट जग बुझ कर रही है, या भी कभी लाइट जल रही है कभी बुझ रही है, जब वो घूम रहा होता है अंधेरे में रात के टाइम, तो इट गिव्स अ ग्लिमरिंग लुक, बार बार जग बुझ वाला, एक बार लाइट जल रही है दूसरी बार बुझ रही है, तो ऐसी जब वो साउंड भी हल्की सी क्रिएट करता है वो म्यूजिकल, एंड वी वुड लाइक टू सी दैट इंसेक्ट ग्लिमरिंग इन द मिड नाइट. And moon a purple glow, and then at the noon time he will have the purple color birds glowing here and there and presenting the atmosphere a lively look. He us atmosphere ko us area ko lively hi dene ke liye, lively means zinda karne ke liye, jaise ki wahan par bhi koi rehta hai, sirf ye feeling dene ke liye ye sare birds aur animals kehta mere aas paas ghoom rahe honge. And evenings full of linnet's wings, and in the evening time he would like to see a small brown and gray bird with short beak. Linnet is also a bird having small wings and brown and gray color with a short beak. Choti si uski chonch hoti hai aur wings hote hain, and this bird here and there just flutters its wings in the evening time. Ye evening time mein ghoom raha hota hai. So he had different timings to enjoy different type of birds and insects for the whole day. That will give him peace of mind, because in the city life he was not getting peace of mind. The life is full of hurry, hustle and bustle, so many tensions, worries, problems, challenges. But in the village life, he would not have any type of stress. He would be getting the peace of mind. He would be enjoying in the company of the birds like cricket in the morning time, and glimmering insect at the bedtime, glowing purple insect in the noon time, and linnets moving here and there, and the sound of music in the evening time. So he would be enjoying the company of these birds and insects, and he would live in peace in that area of Innisfree. I will arise and go now, for always night and day I hear the lake water lapping with low sounds by the shore. While I stand on the roadway or on the pavement's way, I hear it in the deep heart's core. And the last stanza, again he stresses on the desire which she has expressed in the first stanza, and there is repetition of the first line, I will arise and the same line is given in the first stanza also. So this shows, the repetition shows his strong desire, his longing, his yearn to go back to Innisfree, that he wants to go back to Innisfree and to live in that peaceful atmosphere near the lake and enjoy the company of nature. Nature ke beech mein ped, paude, phal, food, vegetables, birds, animals, insects, sab aa jaate hain. So he wants to live in their company and enjoy a peaceful life. What he says in the last stanza again, he says, I will arise and go now. He says, I have got aware now. So I will get up and go now to Innisfree, for always night and day. For he refers to because, क्या रीजन है क्यों वो जाना चाहता है. ही इज टेलिंग अस द रीजन फॉर ऑलवेज नाइट एंड डे दैट मींस फॉर होल नाइट एंड फॉर द होल डे आई हियर द लेक वाटर लैपिंग विद लो साउंड्स बाय द शोर आई कैन हियर द साउंड ऑफ द वाटर लेक वाटर जस्ट लैपिंग एंड प्रोड्यूसिंग लो साउंड्स बाय द शोर किनारों के साथ टकराते हुए पानी जो है वो बहुत हल्की हल्की मध्यम सी आवाज जो है साउंड क्रिएट कर रहा है दैट इज गिविंग मी द डिजायर टू गो बैक टू दिस फील्ड. मतलब वो क्या विजुलाइज कर रहा है अपने सामने आंखों के सामने इसको क्या दिख रहा है वो लेक का पानी जो है वो मूव कर रहा है बार बार वो लैप करता हुआ जंप करता हुआ किनारों से टकरा रहा है और बाहर आ रहा है किनारों से शोर से बाहर आ जाता है और उससे थोड़ी सी साउंड जो है म्यूजिकल साउंड जो है वो प्रोड्यूस हो रही है विद दैट वाटर एंड ही इज विजुलाइजिंग दैट सीन. उसको वो सीन नजर आ रहा है लेक का जो कि उसने अपने बचपन में देखा था. While I stand on the roadway or on the pavement grey, while in the city life, the last two rhymes refer to the city life. He says, while I'm standing on the roadway in the city or on the pavement's grey or on the grey pavements, pavements पर डंडी रास्ता बना होता है जो or on the grey color of pavement where the people who used to go on foot they walk. पैदल चलने वाले लोग जहाँ चल रहे थे साइड में रास्ता सड़क के ऊपर बना हुआ मेन राइट सड़क के साथ साइड वाला जो रास्ता है दैट इज कॉल्ड एज पेवमेंट. ही सेज व्हेन आई एम स्टैंडिंग ऑन द रोड इन द सिटी और ऑन द पेवमेंट दैट इज ग्रे इन कलर इन द सिटी आई हियर इट डीप इन द डीप हार्ट्स ग्लो आई कैन हियर द साउंड ऑफ दैट लेक वाटर डीप इन टू माई हार्ट्स ग्लो. मेरे दिल के अंदर तक के तक जो आवाज डीप गहराई तक मुझे जो आवाज जो है वो सुनाई देती है. See, he has a lot of memories attached of his childhood to that particular place of Innisfree and he remembered that scene of the lake water jumping to the shores coming outside creating low sounds. And then he feels that sound of the scene is just affecting his heart, deep into his heart. And he can hear the sound of that water deep in his heart. Simal ke andar se, dil ke andar tak jo awaaz ho hai, gehrai tak usko awaaz ho hai, sunai de rahi. That means he can clearly visualize the scene and the picture of that lake which he had enjoyed in his childhood period. As a boy, he used to live there, he used to watch that lake and its water, used to enjoy the sound and the music of that water. And now he can visualize that picture. वो उस picture को उस memory को याद कर रहा है उसके सामने बिल्कुल आंखों के सामने वो scene घूम रहा है और उसके दिल की गहराई तक इसका effect जो है वो आ रहा है उसके mind में. So he is feeling very much disturbed and troubled in the city life because city life is full of noise. व्हीकल्स सड़क के ऊपर इतना रश ट्रैफिक जाम हो रहा है लोग इंडस्ट्रीज बनाए जा रहे हैं घरों को तोड़े जा रहे हैं बिल्डिंग्स को नेचुरल सराउंडिंग्स जो है वो हमारी खत्म होती जा रही हैं ट्रीज आर बीइंग कट फॉरेस्ट्स आर बीइंग कट देयर इज नो प्लेस फॉर द बर्ड्स एंड द एनिमल्स टू लिव. यू माइट हैव रियलाइज्ड नाउअडेज पुराने टाइम में हम आकाश में पक्षियों को उड़ते हुए देखते थे कोई क्रो या कोई स्पैरो आपको नजर आते थे. But nowadays, when we look at the sky, we can never see any bird or flying in the sky. Have you ever seen anyone who can explain if there is any experience like that? But I feel like this. Whenever we look at the sky, we are not able to see any bird flying in the sky. But when we were in our childhood, जब हम आपकी age में थे. You can go 40 or 45 years back, there were sparrows, there were crows. We have seen the crows flying on the edge of our roofs. The roof ki chhaton ke upar baithe hue humne kauwon ko chillate hue hawa se nikalte hue suna hai. Sparrows ko dekha hai humne aur birds, parrots, pigeons dekhe hain. तो आप लोगों ने आजकल पैरट्स जो हैं वो सिर्फ क्रो में जिन्होंने रखे हुए हैं वही देखे होंगे. Might never never have seen these birds nowadays. Anyone who can share the experience for this? So we are not enjoying their sound, their musical sound of these birds and insects. Whereas in the ancient times we used to have. So in this way, the poet wants to go to the countryside and enjoy the life near the lake in his free to get peace of mind. Now he is living in the city life and he is feeling tired, stressed, full of worries and tensions, always in hurry and stress of everything. So he wants to come out of this life of the city and wants to go back to Innisfree, where he spent his childhood, and he remembers those memories, childhood memories, and feels happy and wants to enjoy it again in his life, in his old age. Yes, any problem to anyone regarding the poem? If any word or any line is not clear, we are left with 7 to 8 minutes. We can continue with the questions. If there is any problem, you can raise your hands. Yes, Vidya Chahar.
Ma'am, what is the meaning of 9 bean rows?
9 bean rows. Rows kya hoti hai? Lines. Aur bean kya hoti hai? Suna nahi kabhi beans kya hoti hai? Vegetable hai na? Palliyan jisko aap
yes, ma'am.
Here he just wants to refer that he will have 9 rows of greenery. Greenery keh sakte ho, vegetables ho sakti hai, any type of plants ho sakte hai, flowers ho sakte hai. That means he will have greenery around his cottage. It refers to anything green, just okay. Like plants. Yes, any other doubt to anyone? No, I think everything clear. If your hand raised, yes. Come to the questions now. Look at the questions, thinking about the poem. First question, and I request you quickly raise your hands, participate in the discussions, especially those students who never speak, they should come forward. Yes, first question, what kind of a place is Innisfree? Think about. First question, the 3 things the poet wants to do when he goes back there. It refers to stanza number 1. Yes, Parneet Beta.
Ma'am, the Innisfree is a beautiful place where nature is in its full swing.
Yes.
The poet wants to build a small hut of clay and petals. He will have 9 bean rows and a hive for honeybees.
Yes. 3 things you have to mention. First one, he will have a cabin or a cottage made of clay and petals. Then he will have 9 rows of bean, and then he will have a hive for the honeybee. Yes. Next, second part, what he hears and sees there and its effect on him. Refers to second stanza. Yes, you do it up.
Yes, ma'am. In any sphere, a poet at the midnight sees the glimmer of insects. At noon, he sees and hears the sound of purple bird glows. And in evening, he says that evening is full of male swing. And in the early morning, he sees the land full of water droplets of a mist.
Yes, water drops made of mist. So he will see the water drops that were produced by the mist uncovering the morning time, and he will hear the musical sound of the crickets at the midnight, the glimmering of the insects at the noon time, the purple glowing, and in the evening time he will listen to the sound or the music of the linnet. Next, third part. What he hears in his heart's core, even when he's far away from it, is free. Yes, it refers to stanza number 3. Yes, Ram Avasthi. Yes, Pita.
Mom, he hears The lake water lapping the shore with blue sound.
Yes, but your voice is not clear.
Mummy, he is here.
Yes.
The lapping sound of water.
Yes, he hears the lapping of the lake water with low sounds by the shore in the deep heart school. Here. We are leaving it here because the time we started the meeting a little late. Some network.